Yes, sir, welcome back. So in the previous topics, we have been discussing about the fourth model. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the model number fifth, that is per gears and then gear trains. So mainly the things of what we are going to discuss in the mainly is about the different types of gears and what are the applications of different types of gear drives available. So based on that only, we in this model continuously will be discussing about these topics. So mainly in this video we are going to discuss about the introduction to the spur gears. So it is a spur gears is one part and the gear trains is then another part. So in this video we are going to discuss about the introduction to the spur gear. Then we are going to discuss about the spur gear gate terminology. So these are the two topics that we are going to be discussing in this video. So mainly coming to the that is about the gears. So as we know that the gears are one of the essential components, especially in the automobiles where we need to transmit a power for in a small distances, the mainly we are going to use as in a spur gears only. It is not applicable to the spur gears. So we are going to use only the gears in order to transmit a power or a motion for in a very short distance. So especially when using in a vehicles, for example, if you take any vehicle, so we will be using the gears in order to increase or the decrease the speed. The mainly the thing, the thrust what comes is from the gears, gear drives only. So this is what we are going to be discussing in this particularly in this module, that is about the spur gears and then gear trains. So first we will see about the introduction to the spur gears. Yes, mainly the gears whose axles are parallel and whose teeth are parallel to the center line of the gear, that is what we call it as a spur gear. So we are only focusing or we will be discussing related to the spur gears. But what the mainly the general terms of the gears is to transmit the motion between the or to transmit the power between the shaft by using the shafts. But especially when we have been discussing about the only in this video we will be discussing about the spur gears. So mainly the gears whose axles are parallel and whose teeth are parallel, that is both the gear axis and the gear teeth are parallel to the center line, then that type of gears what we call it as spur gears. Mainly the spur gears have been used to transmit the motion between two parallel shafts, mainly wherever we are going to use to transmit the motion between, especially we have been using this spur gears to transmit the motion between two parallel shafts. So that also should able to remember, only it is used to transmit an motion between two parallel shafts. So even it is the spur gears, it is possible to drive the shafts from the parallel intersecting and neither parallel nor intersecting by the use of the gear. So even it can, the drive shafts can able to drive either by intersecting along with the parallel or not even intersecting by the use of the gears. So this is how the spur gears can be classified or how the spur gears can be identified. So mainly it is used to transmit the motion between two parallel shafts. Next, coming to the about the spur gears. So spur gears, the gears whose axis are parallel and whose teeth are parallel to the center of the line, that is what we call a spur gear. It is used to transmit the power between two parallel shafts. Mainly it is widely used for small watches to the gear boxes that is fitted in the airplanes. See, the major application of this type of gear drives are mainly the major applications mainly what we are going to use is about the spur gears. So that is the applications what we are going to use is about from the small gear boxes or the from the small watches what we are going to use from that to the airplanes we are going to use as in a gear drives in order to transmit the motion or in order to transmit the power. So this is how about in a gear drives and particular about the spur gear. So now we are going to be discussing about the terminology of the spur gear. So you can able to see the terminology. So this is just we have been taken as a reference for two teeth which will be there. So what are the terminologies will come into the spur gear? So first you can able to see this is what we call it as in a top land, and this is what we call this portion what we call it as an addendum circle, and this portion what we call it as in a width of the space, and this portion what we call particularly this portion where you can able to see the teeth formation, where that is what we call it as in a pitch circle, and the distance from this point to this what we call it as in a flank, and particularly this face what we call it as in a face, and this will be the bottom land. And the portion below the above the axis line what we call it as an addendum circle, below the axis line what we call it as an detendum circle, between this point can able to see this is from this point to this what we want to measure, that is what we call it as an a tooth thickness. And this portion, see, this is a one complete teeth and then it is moving to the next. So this will be considering as a 2 tilt, and this is portion what we called as a width of the space, and this is what we called as a bottom land, and this is what we called as a dedendum circle, and we can able to see this portion what we called as a fillet radius. And so the distance between these two line and to the lower line to the upper line what we called as a clearance. So between the measuring the distance between that what we called as a clearance circle. So this is mainly about a spur gear technology, sorry, spur gear terminologies. So now we're going to be discussing about the definitions. For example, what is top plan, how we can able to consider the top plan, what is addendum, what is dedendum, what is face width. So in this way we can able to consider all the terminologies with the definitions. Yes, pitch cylinder, mainly the pitch cylinder of a pair, that is what we called as an imaginary friction cylinders that will be rolling together to transmit the same motion. So coming to the pitch circle, so pitch circle is nothing but an imaginary circle which passes through the pitch point having its center axis. See, a pitch circle is nothing but it's an imaginary of the axis of a gear which is imaginary axis which is passing through the pitch point having its center at the axis of the gear, upon which all calculations are made. See, based on this pitch circle, we can able to see this is the pitch circle. Based on this pitch circle, only the imaginary calculations what we going to do is we can able to consider. So next is pitch diameter. The pitch diameter is the diameter of the pitch circle. So the pitch diameter is nothing but it's a diameter of that particular pitch circle. How we going to define the pitch circle? So similarly, based on that only we can able to identify the diameter. Next, coming to the pitch surface. So pitch surface is nothing but the surface of the pitch cylinder is known as a pitch surface. So coming to the line of center, that is a line through the center of rotation of pairing meshes, that is what we called as a line of centers. So next, coming to the pinion, the smallest and usually the driving gear of the pair, that is meeting of two gears, what we called as a pinion. Enable to see this is a fillet radius what we have been discussed. So line of centers, pitch point, pitch surface. Next, when you coming to the rack, it is a part of the gear wheel with an indefinite diameter. And when we come to the circular pitch, if the distance measured along the circumference of the pitch circle from a point to the tooth to the corresponding point on the adjacent tooth, that is what we call it as a tooth thickness. So coming to the pitch angle is the angle subtended by the circular pitch at the center of the pitch circle. You can able to see this. Pitch circle, this is the portion where what we can able to consider for the pitch angle. And coming to the that is pitch angle, the angle subtended by the circular pitch at the center of the pitch circle, what we call it as a pitch angle. So the diametric pitch is nothing but the number of teeth per unit length of the pitch circle diameter in inches, and the limitations of that is not in terms of unit, even we can able to measure the teeth per unit length. So these are some of the basic parts or the basic things of an spur gear terminology. So whenever the mainly we required an to transmit any motion between the gears is at least one or two other teeth should be able to be coincide with another gear drive in order to transmit the motion. Either it might be in the through the parallel shafts or through the any motion. So either it should be coincide, then only it can able to transmit the motion or power. So for that we should able to know the terminologies. So this is what about the terminologies about the spur gears. So most commonly all these type of spur gears gear drives, the same terminology will be, only the few slight changes will be there for the different types of gear drives. So this is about a terminology about the spur gears.